Welcome, everyone. We are so happy to welcome you today to Nextcloud Conference 2020. We are so happy also that so many of you joined us digitally. I hope you will have a lot of fun and that you will also learn a lot. Let's just get started. Here's our first keynote speaker, our CEO, Frank Kalicek. Frank?
Thanks a lot. Thank you, Maria. Thank you, everybody who joins us to this special event online this year. I think it will be a really nice event with a lot of interesting talks, as Maria said. Of course, it will be a little bit different than last year. Here's a screenshot from our conference last year. Usually we do this in person, where we have many, many people here directly to interact, to work together, to have a nice, good time together. Of course, this year is a little bit different, unfortunately. The main reason for that is, of course, our COVID-19 situation that we have. It's a big pandemic all over the world, which changes a lot of things, also here in the Nextcloud universe. So a lot of people think it's already over. It's no problem, which is actually not true. If you look at the numbers, these are the total cases, you see that the numbers still go up significantly. And the number of deaths is also growing a lot. So unfortunately, our pandemic is far from done. There are only a few things we can do at the moment. One is keeping distance and wearing masks. That helps to keep the infection rate under control, hopefully. And also, schools are closed, which is also a thing that affects a lot of parents, unfortunately. Also in companies, the usual crowded offices, like you can see here, they are not happening anytime soon. This is not coming back soon, unfortunately. Crowded meetings like that are also something from the past. So a lot of things change. So it looks like the future looks a little bit like that, where a lot of people do remote work, do home offices, work from the distance, not together with your colleagues in the same room, and of course the same for students and people who go to school and basically all kinds of other meetings. So this is a big change. Of course, this is something where Nextcloud can help, and then I will talk about this a little bit later. Of course, there are already a lot of other companies and products and organizations and solutions who can help with distance working, with distance learning in schools and in companies. But most of them are proprietary centralized internet services coming from the US, for example, which are often very useful, very nicely done, good usability, but you really give up control over your data, over your privacy, over your digital life, and that's something that's not good, especially now that Privacy Shield is no longer valid, as ruled by the highest European court. What's really needed is something different, is a new solution where you can work together from remote work in schools and universities, distance work, distance communication, but keeping your data under control, open source, on-premise. And that's something we want to provide as Nextcloud. We have a nice video that shows you how you can use Nextcloud in from home office situations, and that's actually the first thing I want to show you today.
There are many reasons to work in a home office. There are also reasons not to. Today, it matters that you can get work done from everywhere, on any device. For that, you need the right technology. Even if you are not in your office, you have to keep your data accessible and safe. But how can you avoid having your documents and conversations float around on the servers of a dozen different, often foreign, companies? Nextcloud is a single platform that keeps you productive while your own system administrators manage it in-house. Nextcloud Home Office means to have comfortable access to everything. Manage your emails. Keep your schedule up to date and create video chat rooms for appointments. communicate with chats or video calls, one-on-one or in a team. Share documents and work together on them in real time. No mess, 100% control and transparency. Nextcloud Hub does it all in one package. Yes, that is how I would love to work. Easy and relaxed from anywhere. Nextcloud.
Okay, so I think this is a nice video that shows you how Nextcloud can help in the current pandemic to work from home. It doesn't matter if you're a student, if you're a worker that usually goes to an office, if you're a student, whoever you are, it's a great tool to work together. Of course, today we want to talk about the future. So today we are launching the next big version with Nextcloud Hub 20. But before that, I want to use the opportunity to look a little bit back because it's a bit funny that we actually have number 20 now, the 20th release, and it's also 2020. So we thought it's interesting and good to know what happened in the last 10 releases. And then we created another video that I also want to show you now. Okay, I think it's really impressive to see what all happened in the last 4.5 years, 10 releases. But now I think it's enough to talk about the history. Let's look forward, because today is a big day. Today we are launching Nextcloud Hub 20. Nextcloud Hub 20 is our biggest release so far. There are a ton of improvements all over the place, but in this presentation, I want to concentrate on 10 big topics, 10 big things. So let's get started with the first one. The first one is search. So as you might know, there's already a powerful search feature in Nextcloud for a long time. There's this search button in the header bar where you can click there, and you can find your files. And also the search works in some other places, for example, in the App Store. You can click there and find your apps. But it's not really a unified search. So that's not really something that works like seamlessly between the different functionalities. And that's actually something we are launching now with Nextcloud Hub 20. That's a new unified search, and there's a ton of improvements. First of all, it has a complete new user interface. So we now use the operating system hotkey like Command F that can press in the browser, and it automatically opens this dialog here. and then you can start on typing. And as you type, it actually searches in all different places of Nextcloud your information. You have this nice drop-down here where you can see that you find files and conversations and emails and calendar events and all kinds of things basically combined. You can search for like Christmas party and you find all information related to your Christmas party. It doesn't matter in what application, in what kind of content they are stored, you can find everything. So we implemented a bunch of search providers. There are a lot of places where you can find this information. First of all, files. You can find files based on folder name, file name, but also if you use the full text search like inside the file, you can then see if like a PDF or a Word file contains the keyword Christmas, for example. Then of course we have comments related to files. You can also find files which has the right comments. So if someone commented Christmas party in the file, you can also see it here. You can find talk rooms, conversations, and also messages. So that's also a full text search over all your conversations in Nextcloud Talk. You can find calendar events. You can find project management, Nextcloud deck boards, and also card, project management, to-dos that you might have, mails. So if you use Nextcloud Mail, then all your mail is, of course, in Nextcloud, and you can find all mails that has this keyword, same contacts, your address book, tasks, bookmarks, apps. If there's an app installed on your Nextcloud or comes from the App Store, it's also found, and even settings. So you can even search for settings, and you see, okay, there is now a setting if you want to how to switch to dark mode, for example. You can also find this easily. Okay, but maybe you know that you're only looking for one specific kind of content. Then we have this menu here where you can restrict this to files only or to messages only or to deck only, because then you can actually like nail it down and you can also use a shortcut for that when you type. So this is something that makes it more powerful because maybe you know I'm only looking in chat messages, I'm only looking in emails. Okay, so this is Nextcloud search, the new one, the unified search. And it's a super powerful tool. There's one more thing I want to mention about that, because this is also a great example, and we have more, by the way, but it's a great example where you can see that a seamless integration between the different pieces of Nextcloud becomes really important. Because the question is, okay, why do I use Nextcloud Mail and Nextcloud Talk and Nextcloud Calendar and everything together, and I don't use like 10 third-party tools? Because of exactly this kind of integration. This is exactly the kind of feature that works seamlessly, and this is the strength of Nextcloud to bring all those things together. Okay, so the next feature from the 10 big improvements I want to talk about today is Talk. So Nextcloud Talk is, of course, as you might know, our communication feature. It's used for chatting and it's used for audio and video calls. The chat interface is quite powerful. You can use it for group chats and one-on-one chats. You can do all the usual things. You can post emojis, you can reply to messages, you can mention people that can get a push notification if they're mentioned in a channel. You have moderators who can moderate a conversation, so all the usual features you expect. You can press the start call button, and then a chat room actually converts into a video call. So you can have video calls with lots and lots of people, audio or video or combined. You can have different views. So this is our new grid view, but there's also a presenter view where one person is big and the others are at the bottom in the bottom bar. That's also possible. And there's also screen sharing if you want. So maybe one person wants to share a screen and then the screen is actually automatically put into the presenter view and you see the screen on top of the person. So that's really nice to communicate and collaborate. Another thing that's super important for Nextcloud Talk are the mobile apps. So there are a lot of applications who rely on just normal WebRTC in the browser, and we do this, of course, but we also have native apps for iOS and for Android, and they can really do most of the features directly in the native app on your phone. And that's so much better than just the web view, because you have the native features, and I will show you a few in a few seconds with file uploading. Also, notifications is something. You get like push notification if you're mentioned, or you can get this like on the left-hand side, you can see a calling screen, so you really have a VoIP calling screen if a call is starting. It really looks like a native application, a native communication tool. That's very important. But we improved, of course, these functionalities a lot in the last release. For example, you can upload files directly into a chat channel. And here we have the option now to upload multiple files at the same time. We have a progress bar, which is important if you upload like a big movie file and it takes a while, you can see how long it takes. And we have this confirmation dialog here, where in this case, I dragged and dropped two files into the channel, and then it asks, okay, is this the right files? Click, and then they're in the channel and shared with everybody in the channel. Another thing that's very important is, of course, that it integrates with other applications. So for example, if you're doing editing of a document, here in this case, you can see we are editing a Markdown file, but it's really the same for an Office document, Word, Excel, PowerPoint file. If you drag it into a chat channel, then everybody has access to the file, can click on it, and then the editor opens, and we can all edit it collaboratively together and close it again. And of course, at the same time, it's also stored in the normal Nextcloud files view. So it's really easy to collaborate around files inside Nextcloud Talk. Another big feature, another big improvement we are doing now with the current version is that you can directly upload also from the mobile apps. Because in the past you can only share a file, but here we can really upload directly from the mobile, and we can upload from the files manager, here in this case from iOS, or directly from Nextcloud files, basically from the local files app in iOS or Android, directly into a channel. Another improvement is a new settings dialog where you can configure your microphone and your camera, and there's an overview over the shortcuts, and you just have a bunch of settings to have more control over your call. And then one of the features that are really often requested is, of course, better handling of emojis. Emojis are very important nowadays, as you know, and we have this nice new emoji picker where we have here the common used emojis. You can search for them, you have the categories, everything you expect, so you can really have these rich conversations with emojis. This all already was possible and super easy on mobile devices, but now on the desktop also nicely integrated and built in. Okay, now we're coming to one of the, I think, maybe technically only, but I think really cooler features, which is a way that a chat, Nextcloud Talk chat, can be bridged into other talk rooms somewhere else. For example, you can actually bridge a conversation, a chat channel, basically, to a conversation that's running on a different server. So it can be a different Nextcloud Talk server, and you can bridge it to this other conversation, which means that everything people chat in one conversation is automatically mirrored into this other conversation, and the other way around, of course. But bridging Nextcloud Talk to Nextcloud Talk was not enough. We wanted to make this cooler. We also have this integration with IRC and XMPP, which means if you have an IRC channel somewhere, or you have an XMPP chapter group chat, you can actually bridge the group chat on one side with this Nextcloud Talk room. And then both all the conversations are mirrored in both directions, and we can have a conversation even if the people are not in the same room. And this is something the moderator of a room can set up easily in the sidebar, and yeah, that's quite powerful. The next feature I want to mention is our high-performance backend, because Nextcloud Talk is using WebRTC peer-to-peer by default, and you can have a call with lots of people in the same conversation. But if you're over a certain limit, because everything is peer-to-peer, then you're running out of resources like bandwidth, for example. And for that, we have this high-performance backend, which is a component that has a high-performance scalable signaling server, and also a way to aggregate all the data, all the streams, and send it out to everybody, which is just scales to lots more users. And that's something that's open source. That's a component you can install on a machine and use, and you can configure it. You can see it on top of the screen. But for a lot of users, this is a lot too complicated and don't really want to use it. And I'm really happy that we have this partnership with Struktur AG, another nice open source company. And together there with us, they offer a hosted high performance backend. So if you want to have a call with like 100 people, and we don't have the infrastructure, don't have the server to actually like handle the bandwidth, because it can be a lot if you have 100 people in a room, then you can just use this service, this hosted service from Struktur. With one click, you can actually use that. And there I even have a trial, so if you want to test it, if it really fits your needs in your organization, you can click there and you have a trial and use it. Okay, So for the next feature, which is a very exciting one, I want to ask Jan to come to the stage to tell us more about that.
Thank you, Frank. Hello, everyone at home. I hope you're all staying safe and you're all doing good at home. Thanks for joining us. And I'm happy to announce the next feature, which is very cool, especially in the current situation of COVID-19, where more and more of us are getting used to remote work, and we need to kind of rebuild this team cohesion or the feeling of being in the same office. And it can be difficult. And we, as a remote company, we know all the difficulties of it. So that's why we're super excited to announce the status feature today. So you're basically going to be able to go to the top right in the user menu, and there's this little entry to set your status. So for example, you can say that you're right now preparing the keynote and you do not want to be disturbed, or you can set it to anything you like, basically. So you'll have this, if you click there, you'll have this this modal which shows you all the different options. So for example, if you just set yourself to online, so basically you're available, or you want to be away so people know that you're not available right now. And then there's also do not disturb, as I said. So that also includes that you actually do not get any notifications. So let's say if you're in an important meeting or you're just busy and you do not want to be disturbed at the moment, let's say for preparing the keynote, or you can set yourself invisible to appear offline as well. And then there's also the status messages that you can set. So there you can be more specific about what you're doing right now, or you can communicate to your colleagues what your state is right now. So for example, you can say you're working remotely so that people know that you might have other things to attend to, or you're just working in your home office. You might do things as well in the home, or you're in a meeting. And there, for example, we have these intelligent timeouts as well. So if you're in a meeting, we set it to by default timeout after 1 hour. So after that, it will reset to your regular status. Or you're commuting, for example, maybe for 30 minutes, and working remotely for today, or maybe for longer. Probably it takes a long time for us to still work remotely, and people are getting more and more the hang of it. Or you have a sick day, maybe, hopefully only today, so that's why the timeout is for today. Or you're vacationing, and that doesn't clear, so you're free to vacation. And the important thing here is that this communicates to your colleagues without needing to send everyone basically a message or sending to all your talk channels a message. So this is something that we've been using for some time and that we really like a lot. And this really is a cool feature. So for example, I used to often always mention people in talk channels, and then someone said, oh, they're actually on vacation. And then I checked the vacation calendar, and sure enough, they were on vacation. So this is a very nice feature, which just brings this directly to everyone. Makes it much easier to manage that. And you can, of course, also set a custom timeout for clearing the status message. And then once you set that, what is actually very cool is that it is integrated into all of the different apps. So for example, in Talk, you have in the sidebar, you directly see the status of everyone else. So here, for example, Frank is very busy preparing the keynote, and I'm working remotely. Maria is arriving in Berlin, so we know that she's busy, or she's probably late to respond. And Jos is on vacation, so he will probably not answer. So it's very cool that you directly have an overview of everyone, what they're doing, what their status is, and when I can expect a response from them, probably. And then also where this is integrated is in search. So here in the search suggestions, if I share with a new person in the sidebar in files, I get directly their status in the subline. So for example, Jos is working remotely, or someone else might be busy or vacationing. And then you also know, if I want feedback on that file or on that photo from them, then I can probably expect to wait a bit, or maybe I check the vacation calendar when they're actually back, so that I know that I'm not going to get an immediate reply. And also, this integration is happening in Deck. So there as well, when you assign a user to a card, then you will know, for example, if they're busy right now, or if they're on vacation. So then you know, their assignment, maybe you need to assign it to another person. Maybe you need to check when they're back to make sure that this actually gets taken care of. And so this can also be integrated into other apps. So we have an API for that. And if you develop any apps for Nextcloud, then please check it out so you can integrate it. But already out of the gate, we include it in many of the important main apps. And of course, we're also bringing this to mobile. So right now, this is how it looks in the iOS app. And it will also soon come to the Android mobile app and to the desktop client so that you can set your status and view it, set your status and view other statuses from anywhere. And then you also get this nice overview of people's recent statuses so that you just have this very cool overview of what people were recently doing, but more on that later. So then I would like to hand back to Frank for the next feature. Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot, Jan. It's still a bit weird to do this presentation without applause from the people, but I hope that you're all sitting at home behind your streaming devices and you enjoy this new feature. And as Jan said, I think the status feature is super useful for us. We already tested this and used this for several months, and it's really a good thing. The next feature I want to talk about today is notifications. So notifications are, of course, a very powerful and useful tool to work together in a group, because not everybody is looking at the same screen like all the time to see if something happens. And notifications, specifically push notifications, are something where we can send notifications to people if something interesting happens. And there are all kinds of notifications. I will talk about it for a second. The important thing is, as I mentioned, is that there are push notifications, which means you get them on all your devices. Here you have just an example. I have a smartwatch, I have a mobile phone, can also be a tablet. I have the desktop. On the desktop, you actually get notifications from the Nextcloud desktop client, or here in this case, browser notifications that are also sent directly from your browser. You don't even need to install a client, because browser nowadays can also do notifications. And you get the notifications via all channels. The thing with notifications is, of course, that it can be overwhelming a bit. Maybe you get just too many things and you're just like, oh, another thing happens. And for that, it's very important that you can control them properly. And that's something we really improved a lot in Nextcloud 20, because you have this new notification settings screen where you can actually choose for which events you want to have a notification and for what event not. And you can actually choose to get push notifications on your devices, as I mentioned, or get a mail. There are still people who prefer mail. Maybe some things happen that it's good enough to get them by mail, and other things you want to know immediately. And there are a lot of default actions that are already built into Nextcloud here, calendar and file stuff, but also other applications can also register their notifications, and you can also get them and see them. What's also important is that you can actually select how fast you get the email. So maybe you want to know get the email immediately, or you will want to say, okay, I want to have like only once a month, once an hour, or once a day, or even weekly, actually get what's going on, because I just want to tone down the noise level a bit. It depends on with how many people you're collaborating on how many projects. And of course, there is the option at the bottom where you can say, okay, I really want to have a nice summary of everything that happens in my Nextcloud in the morning. There you get like a notification, an email with all the notifications in it, and you can see, okay, this is what happened. I don't want to like my phone beeping all the time, so it's enough for me to see that. And you really have the choice as a user to control how much you are disturbed. Okay, the next feature I want to talk about today is groupware. Groupware is, of course, a very important component of Nextcloud. With groupware, you mean calendar, contacts, email, and also DEC, our project management tool. And we have like significant improvements in groupware in Nextcloud Hub 20. Let's get started with mail. That's our mail client, which really got a lot of nice features. For example, the threaded view is improved. We have a better folder management. You can really manage your IMAP folders better. That's a lot more powerful and a lot better. And of course, we still have the feature for detecting tickets, itineraries. So if you have a booking for a train trip or a hotel or a flight or something, it's automatically detected. And with just one click, you can actually add it to your calendar and you don't forget it. So that's really, really Nextcloud Mail becomes a really, really nice, powerful tool, especially because, as I mentioned before, it integrates with the whole workflow into everything. The next feature I want to cover is Nextcloud Deck. Nextcloud Deck is a little bit, I think, is the hidden champion of Nextcloud, because it's something that started really as a small project by just one person, but it really becomes a super nice, powerful project management tool, which is nowadays used by a lot of our users and customers. It works as a Kanban-style board, where you can have your different cards that you can move around with drag and drop, and you can have a lot of metadata. You can really say, okay, this is a sound to a person, this is a due date, this is a comment, this is attached file to it, and so on and so on. What we have now is an upcoming cards view. That's important if you work in different projects together, then you have one view where you can really see what's coming, what's really important for you soon. The next improvement here is this new modal view. So if you really work on a lot of details on one card, like as I said, you want to have the tagging or the deadline or signing to someone, writing down the description, then you have this new dialogue, which is really a lot nicer than just on the sidebar. You can still have it on the sidebar. I will show it later in a demo. But this new view is just better for more complicated projects. And then the last thing I want to show you today is that our project management tool, Nextcloud Deck, actually integrates with the calendar. So it really integrates with the calendar. So you have in the Nextcloud calendar a special calendar where you see all the deadlines that are signed in your cards in Nextcloud Deck. And of course, because it's a normal calendar, it's also synced to all your devices, mobile, desktop. You always have like your overview, what's coming up, what's going on. Okay. So next feature I want to talk about is number six. Number six is Office. Obviously, it's a very important feature for people to work together in the Nextcloud environment with Office documents. With Office documents, I mean all kinds of notes, markdown files, but also Microsoft Office documents like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, and so on. And I'm really happy that we have a lot of improvements in all those areas. The first thing I want to mention is our built-in Markdown editor. So as you might know, we have this nice editor that's built in where you can work like with relatively simple documents, like just a headline, a bullet list, some picture, some headline, something like that. And here we have the new improvement that you can also set links to text. So here you can see I marked here text and it shows me the option to add a link to that, and that's actually quite powerful because you can just link to some URL somewhere on the internet, obviously, but you can also link a file from inside Nextcloud, and that's quite powerful because maybe you have different documents that actually belong together somehow, and from one document you can actually link it to another. So it's some kind of wiki that you can actually create here from one document to another. So that's quite nice and powerful, and that's built into every Nextcloud, obviously. But if you really want to work with like really complicated Office documents, then we have our two big technology partners, OnlyOffice and Collabora Online, and those build like full-fledged, like full powerful Office suites that you can use to basically work with all the Office documents that you expect. And I'm really happy that both actually did significant improvements lately to bring this to the next level. Here we start with OnlyOffice. That's the new interface, and they really have cool new features. For example, version history and compare changes. So you can really see like who edited what when, and this is colorly marked. You can see who doing what and accepted changes, track changes feature, and so on. You can mention people in comments, which is quite nice. And you also have like content control over forms creation, a lot more advanced features that you really need in a company environment. But I'm really happy also that our second partner, Collabora Online, also did significant improvements, in this case mainly in the area of user interface, which is something that I think personally is very, very cool. So they actually offer this new ribbon-style user interface, which I think is so much better than the old one. The old one is still available if you prefer, but you can also use this new ribbon interface, which just looks cleaner and easier to understand, better to access the features. And the second thing I want to mention is that we're actually working together with Collabora Online for several months already to basically integrate Collabora Online deeper into Nextcloud, and for specifically, for example, in the user interface area. So here you can see this is just a test build. So this is something, one of the few features that are not done yet. This is a test build where you can see that the colors and the fonts, they match the rest of Nextcloud. And we're working more on icon integration and integration of the toolbar and so on. So this is something where in the future, this will look a lot more native and just will be faster and easier integrated and more powerful. So I think we really have a nice integration, nice improvement in the Office integration area. The next thing I want to mention is desktop, because some people think that Nextcloud is just this web interface, which just our website, which just a web tool, which is not true, because we really care a lot about the desktop experience and also the mobile experience. So the desktop here is something that's very, very important for the story of Nextcloud. And because of that, we develop a very powerful, rich desktop client, which is available for Mac, Windows, and Linux, and provides a lot of functionalities. So the first thing I want to mention is that we actually launched a few weeks ago our version 3.0. That's a major new version of the desktop client, which has a complete new user interface. So this complete new user interface is less technical. It doesn't really talk so much about the syncing, because this all still happens as before, but a little bit more in the background. It's basically the magic that happens in the background. And the user interface focuses more on the things that are interesting for the users. For example, in this case, you can actually see what's going on in your Nextcloud. If someone worked on a project, assigned you a task, if an important email is coming, if you have a mention in the chat, and so on. So really have this nice overview of what's happening. And you can also directly access all the different apps of Nextcloud directly, jump to Nextcloud Talk if you want. So that's more workflow oriented and usable, and also looks a lot prettier, I think. And of course, we also have the notifications, as I mentioned before. So for some of those events, you also get the rich desktop application notifications. The second feature that was very important, obviously still is for the last release 3.0 of the desktop client, is our end-to-end encryption. So our end-to-end encryption is a feature that we developed for quite some time. It took a bit longer than expected, but I think it's a good thing because we really tested this a lot. We really reviewed it a lot. It was audited and checked by security experts. And this is something that's now production ready. And this is part of the desktop client where you can end-to-end encrypt with client-side encryption your secret documents. And even if you don't trust your server admin, if you don't trust your someone who might have hacked your server, I don't know, that they still don't have access to the data because the keys and the encryption, everything is only on the client. The next thing I want to talk about, as mentioned, is mobile. So our mobile apps are very powerful and very important. I'm also happy that we have a lot of improvements in these areas. So let's start it with the Android app. The Android app has an improved user interface, which is a lot nicer. We have integrated a unified search that I mentioned earlier, so that's already available, and also supports, same as a desktop client, the end-to-end encryption feature. And there's a ton more features. I don't have the time to cover everything, but it's something that's really, really nice and powerful, and you can really do like most of your work with the native clients. You can still obviously use the web interface, also works on mobile, it's responsive, but you can really do a lot with the native clients. And native clients are something that's nice because you can work with files offline, for example. You can also receive push notifications as discussed. So you just have the native experience here. And similar, the iOS app. So the iOS app is also something that is very important for us. It has a similar functionality than the Android client. And we also have a complete new, fresh user interface here, which I think looks a lot cleaner and nicer and easier to understand. Also, a lot of improvements went into the media view, the photo gallery view, which is a lot nicer and smoother now. It supports like live photos and has like just better handling of photos overall. It also supports the end-to-end encryption feature, as I mentioned before, which, as I mentioned, is very important because it works across all devices, right? You can synchronize your file with your desktop, access it from one phone, access it from your tablet, from another computer. It's seamless because it's implemented in all our clients. Also the iOS Nextcloud app has a few especially cool features, as I think. For example, text recognition. That's something that's available there, where you can take a photo of something like a printout document, and it can do automatically text recognition and store it inside Nextcloud. And as I showed you earlier with the search, you can also then do the full text search over the document, and you can actually find then the document where you took a photo of. So this all fits nicely together. Okay, so far I only talked a lot about like user-facing features, but the thing is, of course, that it's also very important that Nextcloud improves like the architecture, the security, the performance, and everything, because Nextcloud is used more and more also by bigger organizations. And sometimes you have like a university with like 100,000 students, or you have like, I don't know, a big company, or maybe you have a setup which where people work across the globe. So having something like that, which is really performant, is very important. Also, the architecture is something we always need to keep up to date, obviously, to be work with the latest technologies, work with Kubernetes, and work with object stores and all the modern technologies. And security, obviously. I mean, the whole point of Nextcloud is to have your data under control and secure. If it's not secure, it's completely useless. This is why we also invest a lot in security. So let's go through it. Let's start with performance. So just in the latest version, just in Nextcloud 20, which is just a few months after Nextcloud 19, as I mentioned, we already did a lot of improvements in the performance area. First is the notification system that I mentioned earlier performs and scales a lot better now. So if you have a situation where you have to send a lot of notifications at the same second to like lots of users, then this is something which works a lot better now. Then the preview handling is also improved. I mean, this is a change that really affects big installations. So if you have an installation with hundreds of thousands or maybe millions of users, as we have with Nextcloud, then these improvements where you can distribute the previews over different object store S3 buckets in the backend is something which makes a big difference. And this was all tested in a real life scenario and really makes it scaling to lots of users a lot smoother. Then we did a lot of general database query optimizations. That's something which makes just the overall system faster and, again, scales better. And the mail app, the mail handling in the background was also hugely improved, because if you really have, like, there are people who have, like, 1 million emails in their inbox. I think I'm one of them. and that's something which was a bit of a problem in the past, and now basically all this background email handling is just a lot scalable and a lot faster now. Okay, let's talk about the second topic, which is security. Obviously, security is super, super important. So we, again, use stricter security headers. That's something in the browser that we're just up to date with the latest standards, which really is super important to basically completely block cross-site scripting and other attack vectors. We support WebAuthn standard. That's a W3C standard, which is quite powerful because it automatically makes authentication in Nextcloud compatible with Microsoft Hello or Apple Face ID or Touch ID. So basically all this authentication methods that are built into modern operating systems can then automatically be used to log into your Nextcloud. So that's quite nice. Last thing is architectural changes. This is something, as you know, that we do all the time. So we always improve the architecture. We update it to make it compatible with the latest operating systems and the latest PHP versions and use the latest features. And in this release, we implemented some lazy PHP service initialization, which again makes the scalability a lot better. Another thing that's very, very important and nice is that we use more and more Vue.js, which is a front-end JavaScript library framework, and this has this this concept of components, which is very nice. You basically develop like small components of a software, which you can use in different places. So basically, you need to implement something like you have a file picker, or you have like one selector, or some widget, or something, and you only need to do this once, and you can use it in lots of places. And that's something we really, really do more and more. for example, a sidebar. We have this sidebar which we transformed lately and used view components for that, which really makes it so much easier to develop applications for Nextcloud, because you only need to do it once and then it just like you can use it everywhere, and it's also like pretty and nice and usable and accessible everywhere because you only need to do it once. Okay, so this is just some examples. I don't want to bore you too much with technical things, but Nextcloud is getting better and better with every release. Okay, now this was number 9 of our 10 big improvements. And now I want to move to number 10. And this is a special one, this is a big one. And for that, I want to ask Jan again to come to the stage to tell us more about it.
Thanks again, Frank. And hello again. Hope you're really excited about Nextcloud 20 already. And yeah, we have more, so we're not stopping yet. So the next thing is I really, really like it personally, and I think every one of you will like it as well. It's really like a natural progression of what we've been doing, especially, for example, in January, we introduced Nextcloud Hub, which was all the relevant apps for your workflow in one place in Nextcloud. And now we're going a step further. It's an evolution of Hub. It's basically all in one place, all in one overview. And so we'd like to show to you today the Nextcloud dashboard. So it's one overview of everything that you have. It has these widgets. So for example, here we see recommended files, talk mentions, upcoming events, recent statuses. So it ties into the apps that we already have, into files, into talk, into calendar, into mail, and a lot more apps. It ties into the new status feature. You can directly change the status from there. You can change the weather from there. So you have it all in one overview. And what is really cool about this is that it always shows you the relevant information. So for example, for files, it shows you the recommended files that you might already know from the files on top of the files app. And in talk, it shows you the latest mentions. So where you were mentioned. So it's always relevant to you. When there's no mentions, you get this nice no unread mentions. So like you're kind of done inbox zero, and you still get the other conversations. For upcoming events, also you get either feedback if there's, for example, no events today, or if there are events, you get the upcoming ones. And so of course for statuses, as I was already teasing before, you get the status overview of the people who is on vacation or who is currently working remotely. And so from here, you can also see that you can directly there see and change your status. So there we made it even more present a bit. And when you click that, it's the same thing as if you would do it in the top right. You get this modal. You already know about it. You can change your online status. You can set do not disturb. You can set your status messages. So directly from there, if you start your day, you can basically set what is the mode for today. So this is something that is really the whole dashboard is also something where the idea was, what do you do with your morning coffee, for example? Yeah, you have this overview. You need to set your status, what you're going to be working on maybe, or what's your current status really. And then another feature that is really useful for that is that we have direct weather integration. So here it directly shows you the relevant weather from Berlin in this case, and it shows you a few hours in advance so that you actually know, well, will it rain later? So do I need to bring an umbrella? And so it just shows that directly there. And of course you can change the location if you're somewhere else, or it also uses the browser's location. So basically it's all pretty much automatic. And that's a really cool integration because that just directly works and you don't need to set anything. You don't need to connect to any weather service because we're doing all that for you. And then of course, one thing that you can do, everyone likes that, customization. You can suit this dashboard to your needs. You can change the widgets that are being shown. You can, if you don't want the weather, if you don't want to hear anything about there being rain, you can just disable it. You can not show the status feature, but more importantly, you can add all sorts of different widgets from all sorts of different apps. So for example, the Deck app has a widget, the Notes app, lots of community apps like Analytics, like there's a whole bunch of widgets out there. So yeah, when you update to Nextcloud 20, make sure to check out the customization screen so that you see what else is out there and what you can enable. And then of course, what you can also do is you can change the background. So by default, we have a beautiful blue cloud background, but there's also a ton of Creative Commons licensed pictures, and they all look really cool. And of course, you can also pick your own picture. So you see it right there, you can pick it from files, and then you can just customize it completely. So yeah, that's the dashboard. We're super excited about it because it really this is the new experience for Nextcloud. So you're not landing anymore in files, you're landing in the dashboard because Nextcloud is more than just files, right? It's the files, it's talk, it's events, it's mail, it's calendar, contacts, and so on, everything, right? It's the whole collaboration experience. And with this, we really think that this brings it all together, right? It brings it into one place, in one overview, and when you're either back from vacation or when you start your day, and you have all this overwhelming deluge of information, like you need to check your mail, you need to check your talk, this kind of helps you to kind of focus and only do one thing and see what is really important at the moment. And so to see more of that, I would like to now switch to a demo and show you more of that in action. Yeah, so there we go with the dashboard. So this is how it looks like. And there we go with the good morning, and it will automatically switch to good afternoon, of course, wherever you are. And here you can set your status. So right now, for example, we're actually not anymore preparing the keynote, so we can say we're giving the keynote. And we can say, well, we're going to clear it in 30 minutes, maybe we're done. Yeah, let's see. Maybe in an hour. Let's see. So we can set the status message, and then you see it's reflected in the status. And that's the same, actually, as here in the top right. So, and this in the top right will show in every app, but for the dashboard, we thought it would be cool if we would really give it a bit more presence, even the status feature, because it's such an integral part of your day and what you communicate to others. So we gave it the extra presence here. And then the weather, of course. Oh, it's partly cloudy, but it's actually nice temperature, so that's cool. If I want, I can change the location. So if you're going on vacation or something, you can check it here real quick as well, but only for the current day right now. Plan is also to add more info to that. Right now it's the same day. And then, of course, we come to the widgets. So the really interesting part, first of all, the recommended files. So this is based on, for example, files that have been recently edited or that have recently been shared with you. So oftentimes, for example, when we have a company meeting, it's really cool because the minutes or the meeting notes will directly show up there because they've recently been edited. So you can just go in there and open them and can basically just open them directly. Yeah? So you can, for example, an image you can directly view from here, or folders you can directly open from here. You can open a file, for example, and here you can do Christmas party planning directly from here, or you can close it again, and you can also share it. You have the sidebar there. Everything is directly there. So you're directly in the dashboard, and you don't have to leave it to actually do things. Then the next thing is a talk mentions. So I said that when you get mentions, you actually get the mentions nicely shown here. But when there's no unread mentions at the moment, you still get relevant info. So for example, here the recent messages, and then when you click them, you go to talk, and that actually takes you out of the dashboard. But then of course you can go back again. And similar with upcoming events. So here it's very cool, very nice overview. You see, oh yeah, you need to book the photographer until tomorrow and do the Christmas party planning and decide a dress code. So you all have this in this one overview. You don't need to necessarily switch to the calendar. You can, of course, if you have more planning, but this shows like all the upcoming events that are important to you, and it especially focuses on the events that are today. And in this case, you also know you're good for today. So this actually gives you feedback that this is all done, so you can focus on the other things. And this, I think, is also really important, that it also gives you this kind of feedback and this kind of safety or feedback that you're actually done and that you can do other things. You can focus on other things because it's not meant to pull you in. Yeah, it's not meant to take your attention, but it's meant to give you the relevant stuff, and then you're done with it, basically. And here we saw what I showed before briefly, the recent statuses. So for example, Jan or me, I'm Frank here. So Jan is working remotely, actually. Maria is arriving in Berlin. Toby is also there, and Jos is vacationing. So here you see a nice little overview of the other people, of your colleagues. And so, yeah, this is quite cool. And yeah, people are also setting funny status messages. So here you can check out the newest emojis to use and the latest funny status messages. And that's kind of nice. And then, of course, when we scroll down here, we see the customize button. So you can already to your liking, drag and drop the widgets. So for example, here you can say, well, upcoming events is something more important to you, or maybe recommended files you want at the end. But what is really cool is this customize. So when you open that, you see more widgets. So here, for example, is the upcoming cards view from Deck, or the important mail from mail, of course. And here you can also, for example, remove widgets. So for example, you can say, maybe recommended files I don't actually want, or the talk mentions maybe I don't need at the moment, and you can suit it to your liking. And here as well, you can just drag them around like you want in whichever order you like. And then, of course, here you see get more widgets from the App Store, because you can install a lot more apps that are currently already supporting widgets, like I said, like the Notes app, the Analytics app, and way more apps. So that's really cool. You can really personalize it to your heart's content. And there's another thing that I'm also really excited about, also because I spent a lot of time curating all these nice pictures that are all Creative Commons licensed, is that you can customize your background. So very easily here, you can just set a nice background picture and to kind of set your favorite background just like on the desktop. So here you have a nice picture, or if you want a maybe more colorful one, you could go with this one, for example. And here you also, for example, see it directly automatically switches the icons to dark so that you see them better, the navigation icons. And then you have the other widgets. So for example, mail account, you can from here set up the mail account. And
okay, I hope you're all back. I'm really, really sorry. We have some technical difficulties, actually a power outage. That's quite interesting what happens sometimes. So I'm really sorry for that. I hope you all use the time for some bio break and grab a coffee or something in the morning. But now we are back. So again, sorry for that. Okay, so as Jan just showed you, our new dashboard is quite powerful and also very useful, obviously. That's something we actually worked on for several months in internal testing and with several iterations around it to make it really useful and not just a gimmick, but something that really improves your productivity and your life, obviously. So as mentioned, we have all the different components. We have the files, we have the talk mentions, we have the status changes, and so on. And of course, you can even from there directly jump into the right app where something is happening. For example, here in Talk, where you can see, okay, here is some discussion happening in about a Christmas party and the Christmas party channel, where I can just then directly click here. And then I jump directly into the right conversation, and I can really see what's going on and participate in the conversation. Or, let's going back to the dashboard, if you see in the recommended files, by the way, is a feature where we use some intelligence to really recommend the interesting files for you that you might be interested in. And as Jan showed, you can already directly open Office documents and pictures there, but of course you can also jump directly into the right folder. You click here, then you end up in the Files app, and basically directly in the right location. Okay, let's show you a little bit more about the Files app. It's of course a good way to upload all your documents, you know, and organize them in folders. You can favorite them, you can share them with others. You can also here select what you shared with others, what is shared with you, what is shared by link, and so on. As you know, you can tag documents, you can have favorite documents, look at the recent documents, and so on, all the usual features you expect. On top, again, we have the recommended files, as lots of you might know. And then we have this new feature here since a few months where you can actually document the folder. For example, if you go into the Christmas party folder here, that you can see that here on top we have this documentation where you actually describe to your colleagues what's going on, what kind of documents are there, and you can directly click in there, and you can of course edit it. These are important files or something, And everything is stored then in this README file, which means it's also synced to your desktop and accessible from the command line and everywhere where you want to access it. Obviously, you have the documents here. For example, it's PDF. You can directly open this nice Christmas song PDF if you want to celebrate Christmas with some nice music. You have some pictures and everything you expect. A cool new feature that we actually introduced in Nextcloud Hub 20 that I haven't mentioned before is something which I think is very cool if you share a file. Yeah, let's share this nice picture here with someone, where you have here on the sidebar the option to share a link. You can press here, and you created the share link, and obviously you can customize it as before. But the new thing here is that you can actually give it a title. You can say that this is like a secret link or something. And then actually you can see that this link is here has a name. And you can do this with several links, and links can have different permissions and different names, so you can actually know which link you send to whom. So that's a nice new feature to organize your workflow that we haven't mentioned before. Then, of course, you have the usual other applications. Oh, by the way, maybe I should talk a little bit about the navigation. As Jan already mentioned, we did some fine-tuning here. So as you can see, we have now space for more applications here in the header. That's also an often requested feature. And we have this nice animation here, which helps to highlight the current application. And you also have more space for more text, so the text is not clipped. So this is all like improved. But let's go through it a bit. Let's click on the first one, Photos, which again gives you a nice overview over all your media files, where you can then directly open it and share them and talk about it and so on. Then the activity view, that's something you of course know. It's very useful because you basically see a timeline of all the changes that happen in your Nextcloud, and you can filter them, what you did, what others did, what happened with your favorite files, and so on and so on. But let's go into Nextcloud Talk, because there we actually have some nice improvements, as I mentioned before. As I said, we have the side channels here, we have the conference side channel here, we have the Christmas party side channel, and again, I can share pictures in there and images and office documents. Let's see, maybe share, I don't know, here, another nice picture here, click, and then this is shared with everybody in the channel. And I can do the same with office documents and edit them together collaboratively. That's quite nice and powerful. And as I mentioned, we have this nice emoji picker. So you can click here, and you have all the emojis, and then you can also search for nice Christmas-related emojis. I don't know, here, that one looks nice. And then, yeah, you can actually communicate with nice emojis and pictures and document with your colleagues and your coworkers and your friends. That's nice and powerful. In the settings here, in the sidebar, we still have the option to combine a chat channel with a project management board with a shared folder and with other resources to bind them together into projects. But now the new thing is, of course, that we also have like this new way to select your devices. Oh, I can even see myself, fancy, and your microphone. And here you can configure, for example, where all the documents that are shared into a channel are stored. You have a shortcut for your documentation for your shortcuts and all the other settings you might have. So that's quite nice, powerful production tool. Then let's go into DEC. That's our project management tool. Here we have this mentioned upcoming view where you can see everything that's going on combined from all projects. But let's go into one thing here, the Christmas party, where you have the different cards. So as I mentioned, we can nicely just drag and drop, like move them around here. If something is done or not done, that's nicely visual and drag and drop. And then obviously you can go into the details, have this sidebar that you can open if you want. Let me see. That's the sidebar that you can open if you want. Doesn't want to, okay. But you can, now it opens. It's maybe a slow network. There you can have all the details here, where you can assign it to people, assign text, have due dates and so on, attachment to files, comments and timeline and so on. And we have this new modal view where you can actually press here and you see then everything in a bigger in a bigger view. That's quite quite useful if you have more detailed descriptions and more just more information around it, more than you just want to cram into the sidebar. Okay. Yeah, and as mentioned before, if you go to the calendar again, let me see, here's this new Christmas deck party calendar where you can already see the due dates, the deadlines that I configured in the project management tool. So that's another example where everything nicely nicely binds together, same as with the search. Can do this for Berlin, and you can see like the different things here again, the chat channel that I can jump to. Okay. So this is a nice overview of all the major features in Nextcloud 20. Let me actually then jump back here. So I think Nextcloud 20 is a really nice release. We invest a lot of energy into bringing all the pieces together, have the unified dashboard, have the unified search, the status feature that shows in all the different pieces. And this is something that really, as I mentioned, we tested this internally already. This really improves the productivity of our team a lot. But this is only half of the story. So Nextcloud 20 is actually only half of the thing that we wanted to show you today, because there is something more. And that's what we call the Nextcloud platform. Okay. So let's bring this into context, what we want to say with that. As you might know, this all started with a file synchronization tool. So this all started with a file sync and share solution, something like you bring in your files, you share them with other people, you sync them with your devices, and this was basically the core functionality of everything. But as you might know, earlier this year with Nextcloud 18, Nextcloud 18 Hub, we actually expanded what we want to do with Hub to become a full collaboration suite. So we really made like the talk and the video calling and the office component and the calendar and email and notes and all the different components, basically all made them first class citizens and brought them together into one solution that basically covers everything that you need to collaborate. But this again is for us only one step, because there is actually something that comes after that. And this is something that we call the Nextcloud platform. Platform means that we want to encourage a lot of other developers to build applications on top of Nextcloud. And it also means that we want to talk and communicate with all other software services, solutions, open source or not open source, that's available. Basically bring everything together to basically maximize the productivity of the users, to become like the central component, a central hub again, where all the different pieces are connected. And again, these are like applications that are built specifically for Nextcloud, for Nextcloud Hub, or things that we integrate. So as you know, we already have a lot of dedicated applications for many, many years in our App Store. So we have our App Store where everybody can publish extensions and applications, and lots of examples for that. You really should have a look. That's really amazing. New stuff pops up all the time. But that's only the first step, because we really want to focus on bringing this to more users and also to work on integrations. Integrations means we want to connect other software into the Nextcloud ecosystem. And for that, we did several things this time. The first is we have this new category called integrations in our App Store. This is a place where you can publish connectors and extensions where Nextcloud talks to other software. This is not software that's specifically done for Nextcloud, but something we integrate. And we have this new category there, and everybody can upload it with an App Store in our App Store and make it available to all Nextcloud users. Of course, this all can be accessed from inside Nextcloud too. So we have this very nice app management, extension management inside Nextcloud. This is the screen where you have these categories on the side. Again, you can see the integration category, the new one, and you have all these apps. Again, you can also find them with our new unified search too. And on the sidebar, you can see the screenshots, the descriptions, and a new thing we added here is the change log. So you can even see what happens in the, or what was improved in the last version. Okay, so this is a nice way where everybody who wants to connect to the Nextcloud ecosystem, to the Nextcloud platform, can easily publish their their apps, their extensions. Okay. But then, of course, the question before that, how do I actually develop this kind of connectors and extensions on top of it? And for that, APIs are super important. So really need like nice, documented, stable, standardized APIs to connect different software pieces together. And for that, we actually launch a new initiative, a new standard called the Open Collaboration Services Standard. The Open Collaboration Services, this is an API standard that we push forward. It's already obviously supported by Nextcloud, but already from other software too. And we want to work with more platforms, more solutions to also support the same API, which means then applications will be compatible between different platforms. So this should be an open standard. It's based on open source implementations, open documentations, and basically everybody can use it and can use it to integrate their services with each other. That's called Open Collaboration Services. We have a nice website, opencollaborationservices.org, where you can see the basic information, what it is, how it works. And of course, we have our actual API documentation where you can see, okay, how can I authenticate? How can I share something? How can I access a file? How can I write a widget? And so on and so on. So we have all the documentation in place. Of course, we still have our developer portal. So our developer portal on the Nextcloud website is a place where you can go if you want to start writing an application or integrate into the Nextcloud platform. Here you have information how to set up a development system, how to make an application that's secure and well-designed. We have our guidelines there. We have a tiny application generator even there. You can just like fill in some metadata, and there's a basic boilerplate application generated for you that you just can take that's already completely working and running, and you can use it to fill in your business logic, and you already have a widget or connector or search provider or whatever. It's quite easy. If you have more questions, there are also links to our developer forum where you can communicate with others, and we even have a new developer chat channel using Nextcloud Talk, obviously, where you can directly talk with other people and ask questions. Hey, how can I do this? How can I do that? So really want to encourage everybody to connect to Nextcloud, to the Nextcloud Hub, to work together to build this environment where you can be productive but still secure and protect your privacy, obviously. Okay, now you might think that, okay, this is nice in theoretical, right? Does this really work? Well, the thing is we didn't stop there because we actually, the last few months, developed a lot of these integrations ourselves and also in collaboration with other companies and other organizations and open source projects. So we have a bunch of applications already ready and a bunch of integrations already ready that I want to talk about now. Okay, let's get started with the first category. That's something that is about social and communication. So the first thing I want to mention is our integration into Discourse, into Reddit, and into Twitter. But these are obviously services on the internet that are very popular. This is a bit of a surprise because the dashboard widgets that Jan showed earlier, these are not all. So we actually have a lot more. And here are three of them. You can actually directly access these other services, which don't come from Nextcloud, obviously. They're third-party services. But they can talk with standardized APIs to Nextcloud, and you can show the information directly on the dashboard. So you just go to the apps page. You download, Discourse app. And then you have this new plugin that you can use on your dashboard. Then, of course, you might wonder, okay, how do I actually authenticate? In the settings, we have a new section called linked accounts, and for all the accounts, there is then the automatically shows a section that shows up. In this case, Twitter with a button connect to Twitter, and then the authentication process works. Like OAuth, for example, you click there, and then you're basically connected your Twitter account to your Nextcloud account, and then you have the widget, and you can do all the information. Of course, all those services I mentioned earlier, they're like centralized proprietary services. We like open source and decentralized services more. This is why we also integrated with the Mastodon community. The Mastodon community is, of course, a very nice decentralized open source community, very similar to Nextcloud, and they're building this decentralized Twitter alternative, and they have another dashboard there where you can see all the dashboard notification and the Mastodon notifications in your dashboard. And again, you can directly click on it and jump to the right conversation. But here we want to do a little bit more. And as you might know, we have Nextcloud Social, which is actually a social network component that is using the same APIs as Mastodon. So this is the ActivityPub API. That's a standard from the W3C, using the same API than the Mastodon community, which means you can actually see the same messages here that you see on your Mastodon server, your Mastodon client, and it's really compatible and fully integrated. Okay. So this is about social network. Let's talk about the next thing, which is video calling. So of course you might know this nice project called Big Blue Button. They are a nice open source decentralized video calling solution. And I'm really happy to say that we have nice deep integration into Deep Blue Button now. So not everybody's using Nextcloud Talk yet. Some might use some other solutions like Big Blue Button. And for that, you can just install the app. And then here in the settings, you can configure your rooms, your conversations. And then it's deeply integrated here in this case in the Nextcloud files in the drop-down where you can then jump directly to the right conversations. And it's really nicely integrated and quite powerful. This was done by one of our community members, by Klaus, who actually will give a talk about this integration later. So this is a nice nice example where we can show that we as Nextcloud don't only want to work with our own components, but we want to work with everybody. We really want to bring everybody into the same experience so they can collaborate together in the same way you want. Okay, let's talk about the next integration that we did the last few months is Rocket Chat. Rocket Chat is a chat solution that's also, again, open source. And it works very similar to Nextcloud Talk. Again, we, of course, prefer Nextcloud Talk. But if you want to use Rocket Chat for whatever reason, that's totally fine and is totally integrated. For example, you can inside Rocket Chat directly already, if you receive an attachment or a picture in this case, click on the button and directly save it into Nextcloud. And the other way around, if you want to post a picture from your Nextcloud into a Rocket Chat chat channel, that's also possible. Okay, let's talk about the next integration because we, again, didn't stop there. We really wanted to do more. Matrix, again, you might know, is another very nice decentralized communication solution and framework. And here we also developed very nice integration. The first is that we have a dedicated app, dedicated interface. It's the Element web interface that you can then use directly inside Nextcloud. Really, basically, as one piece, it's fully nicely integrated, and you can see it. You can chat and communicate with your Matrix friends directly from inside Nextcloud. But again, we didn't want to stop there because we want to really combine Nextcloud Talk even closer with Matrix. And here we implemented something very cool. We implemented another with the MetaBridge community, another bridge to Matrix between Nextcloud Talk and Matrix. Remember when earlier I talked about Nextcloud Talk, it has support for this bridging feature. You can bridge IRC channels and XMPP channels into Nextcloud Talk bidirectionally. Well, that's not all. We have more of those connectors and we have more of those bridges. For example, here, Matrix. So that's quite cool. A moderator can just set this up in Talk, and then everything you write in one channel in Talk appears in Matrix. And everything you write in the Matrix channel appears in Nextcloud Talk in both directions. So that's super useful. Of course, not everybody is using nice open source software yet. Some are still stuck in centralized services. A very popular one is Slack, as you might know. I personally don't like it too much. It's too centralized and proprietary, but it's very popular. And again, for Slack, we also developed a bridge. So there is now a Slack to Nextcloud Talk bridge. So if you want to use, or you have to use, I guess, a Slack channel for something, You can actually connect this to your Nextcloud Talk channel. You can use your native Nextcloud Talk mobile apps, all the workflows, the search, everything you want as before. But every message you write is automatically posted to the Slack channel and in the other direction. So that's a great example where we really want to work with everybody, even with the solutions that we're actually competing with, like in this case, Slack. Okay, so this was the first segment. This is about communication on social. Let's talk about developer integration. Obviously, in Nextcloud community, we have a lot of developers, and we really care about using different tools and connecting them nicely together. So the first thing that I want to talk about is GitHub. GitHub is, of course, a centralized code collaboration platform where you can write code, and we know it quite well because we actually use GitHub for developing Nextcloud itself. So we are also, Nextcloud is developed on GitHub, as you know. We developed nice integration into GitHub, which again, we have another widget that we didn't mention before, where you can see all your GitHub notifications directly on your dashboard. So the real story of the dashboard that we didn't mention before is that it really gives you an overview of everything that's interesting for you. Not only what's interesting inside Nextcloud. Really all the services that you use are basically shown there. You can download the app and configure them, and then you see all your GitHub notifications also in the Nextcloud dashboard. Another thing we did is we integrated into the unified search. So as we showed you earlier, in the search, you can find like all the data in your calendar, in your contacts, in your files, in your chat, in your project management, in all your sources, in your bookmarks, and so on. But you can also find them in external integration services. In this case, we implemented a GitHub search inside the Nextcloud unified search, which means if you type in Christmas party, you not only find your own pictures and chat messages and files, you can also find GitHub tickets and pull requests and things on GitHub in the same search overview. I think this is quite powerful and quite nice for a lot of people. Of course, GitHub, again, is a centralized service, and we prefer open source decentralized services more. This is why we did really exactly the same for GitLab. So GitLab is the decentralized open source alternative to GitHub, where, again, we have a dashboard widgets with all the up-to-date GitLab notifications and the integration into the search. And I'm really happy about that because this is a feature we actually developed together with GitLab. And here we have this nice quote from Brandon. He says, "It's great to see an open source project like Nextcloud integrate with GitLab, providing value to our shared customers and users across the globe. The power of open source is deep integration and collaboration, and this development is a great example of that." Yeah, I couldn't agree more. That's the power of open source, that all these different projects can actually work together and basically together provide the user experience is really nice for the end users. And I'm really happy about this GitLab integration that we did the last few months. So the next service I want to mention is Jira. Jira is a very popular issue tracker that you also might know. And again, with Jira, we have nice integration. We have another dashboard widget that you can use. Again, please only select the ones that are useful for you, please. But then you have your Jira notifications directly on your dashboard. And again, integration into the search too. So if you search for Christmas, you can also like find your tickets in Jira directly in the same search results. You can click on them and directly jump to it. So that's quite nice. Here we did a little bit more and even integrated the notifications. So if you actually have a notification, for example, if you have a new open ticket in Jira, it's automatically communicated to Nextcloud and it's triggered like a normal Nextcloud notification that you receive on your phone and tablet and all your devices, and it's just part of your normal workflow. You don't really notice it, that it's not the same software. Well, it's obviously a different software, but it's the same process and the same experience connected together. Okay. So this was the developer experience. Now I want to talk a little bit about education. Education, that's a topic for me which is really close to my heart, especially now with distance learning and what's happening with COVID-19 and in schools that are closed partly. That's something that's really, really important. And here I'm really happy that today we are announcing a close partnership with the HPI School Cloud. So HPI School Cloud is an open source e-learning solution, which is developed by the HPI, and it's actually publicly funded, and it's completely open source, and it's very popular in a lot of schools. And but they're focusing on e-learning. They have all the e-learning functionalities that don't really have the collaboration features that we have. So this is a very natural partnership that we have here. We're working together with them for several months already. We are implementing talk integration, files integration, calendar integration, and a lot of new things. So really stay tuned. There's a lot of cool things are coming. And if you're looking for a solution for a school that basically combines the power of Nextcloud combined with the power of a real e-learning solution like from HPI, and you all want it open source and GDPR compliant and running locally and compliant and integrated, then I think this is a very nice solution. Of course, the HPI School Cloud is not the only relevant solution. There's also Moodle. So Moodle is a really, really nice project, another e-learning solution. They're really friends from Nextcloud. We're working together for many, many years. And here we already have a lot of nice, cool features. For example, again, another dashboard widget where you can see everything that's going on in Moodle directly inside Nextcloud. And the search integration, where you can, inside the search, you can find your courses, your module, your events, everything that's important for you that's happening in your school, direct, or your university, or whatever you do, directly inside Nextcloud too. And inside Moodle, you already have the option that you can select a file from inside Nextcloud and basically integrate directly into your Moodle data. Maybe it's a course or some class, something you do, you can really link this together based on files. This, by the way, was really improved lately, where the whole authentication flow is a lot nicer now, a lot better for the normal users. So here I have another quote from my personal friend Martin, the founder and CEO of Moodle. He says, "The crisis has increased the need for online collaboration solutions, and Nextcloud and Moodle are extremely popular in the education space. An expansion of our integration as initially developed in 2017 is set to benefit millions of students and teachers." Yeah, exactly. So this is a long-time partnership where we bring our solutions together, and I think together this is a really nice answer for the problems that schools have at the moment with COVID-19. I'm also happy to say that maybe you saw it in the schedule already, that Martin will also give a keynote at our conference here this year, and he will talk a little bit more about our integration, how this all works together. Okay, let's go to the next segment, that's productivity. Again, we didn't stop there. We really wanted to do as many of nice example integrations as possible to show how Nextcloud can become a platform that works with everybody, that brings everybody on board and provides one unique user experience for the optimal productivity. So the first thing I want to mention here is Office again. As I showed you before, we have our two very close technology partners, OnlyOffice and Collabora Online, and they both have very nice online Office solutions that tie directly, deeply into Nextcloud. But of course, there are more options. And there's another nice online office developed by Hancom. So Hancom is a company from South Korea, and they actually have a very powerful, very nice online office. And this is something that we also now fully integrated into Nextcloud lately. So you can just click on a Word file or Excel file, and you can open it directly in Hancom Office. It shows up inside your Nextcloud. It has a sidebar with Talk, where you can chat around it. You can do collaborative editing. You have a video call while working on the same document. Same is with these other solutions. So that's just another option. Right? This is not like replacing anything. Right? It's not replacing one of the other solutions. The whole Nextcloud platform idea is all about choice. We want to work with everybody. We want to bring everybody into the Nextcloud user experience. And now we have another option for online offices deep inside Nextcloud. Here's another screenshot of the presentation module. It's actually, it's very nice. You really have to try it. It's quite powerful. And another spreadsheet screenshot. Like I said, we're working together with Hancom for several months already. We have another quote here from the president of the Hancom group, which says, with this Nextcloud partnership, Hancom will bring Hancom Office Online, its flagship cloud-based office productivity application, into the world's most popular on-premise content collaboration platform. So, yeah, this is a very nice partnership, Hancom. They are very active in the Asian and in Asia, one of the most popular offices there, and I'm really happy that we're working together there. Another integration I want to feature here is Kaspersky. That's something we mentioned or we launched a few weeks ago already. Inside Nextcloud, you already have the virus scanner app that lots of users use, and we can use all the usual open source virus scanners there. But there's this new option that you can also use Kaspersky if you want to. Obviously, Kaspersky is a proprietary commercial software. You have to pay for it. You have to buy it. Maybe you get a little bit more. It's definitely different than the open source scanners out there. And that's something you can integrate directly into Nextcloud, again, using our open APIs here. And you can use that. That's now fully supported. So Alexandra, the head of Kaspersky Technology Alliance, says the integration of Kaspersky anti-malware technology into Nextcloud product provides its customer with the certainty that files accessed through or downloaded from their content collaboration platform will be secure. But that's just a way to secure your files inside Nextcloud. So the next integration I want to talk about is Zamat. So Zamat is a very nice ticketing system. It's open source on-premise, so it really fits into our philosophy. We are talking with the Zamat people for a long time. The reason is that we actually use it ourselves. So in our support system, in our internal support system that we use for our customers, we actually use Zamat. So because of that, of course, this was an obvious example where we really want to basically build very nice deep integration into the software each other. Again, we have a dashboard widget, so if you are Nextcloud and a Zamat user, you can use this widget and you see all the notifications, all the status changes of the different tickets that you're working with directly in your dashboard. And again, the search integration, where if you search for something like a customer name, for example, you can not only see like the folder and the chat conversations and the calendar entries, you can also see the tickets in Zamat directly in the same search result. So again, full overview over everything, which is quite nice. And again, we integrated the notifications. So you get like notifications for Nextcloud, also for things that happen in Zamat. So in here an example, you can, for example, receive it on a watch or smartphone, or it doesn't matter. You can directly see what's going on. So really nicely connected experiences. So Martin, the founder and CEO of Zamat, says Zamat enables users to manage tasks and incoming customer requests. Open source, self-hosted cloud technologies allow networking integration with each other. That is, again, that's the power of open source, that we can work together. Okay, so now I'm coming to the end of my list, and I want to talk a little bit about some other software, which is there's something that we compete with. But we still want to integrate with software, even if they're competitors of us. The reason is that sometimes if an organization is moving away from decentralized proprietary software platforms to self-hosted open source decentralized platforms like Nextcloud, sometimes you can't do the migration all in one step. Sometimes you have the migration piece by piece. So sometimes we hear from our users that it's still useful to have some of those older platforms before they move step by step to Nextcloud. Another thing is, of course, that if you're working together with organizations, with partner companies, for example, suppliers, other companies, sometimes they use other software, proprietary centralized software solutions. So it is valuable to have this integration with these other platforms. And I have like three examples here to show you. First is Dropbox. Dropbox obviously is a competitor to Nextcloud. but we have this nice external storage connector. So inside your Nextcloud, you can mount your Dropbox as a folder directly inside your Nextcloud. And this can be used to access your Dropbox files because maybe you have a shared folder because they're used in some other project and you can't change it. You can still pull it in into your Nextcloud and use it just on part of your normal workflow. And of course, you can also use it to migrate. You can just take the files, drag and drop them from the Dropbox folder into your Nextcloud folder, and then the files are migrated. So actually, this is a very nice feature. The second company I want to mention is Google. Google, obviously, with G Suite, they also have in Google Drive and other solutions, they obviously have services and software that are competitors to Nextcloud. But again, we want to be open and working with everybody because, as I said before, there are some scenarios where you actually have to be interoperable. The first is Google Drive. Google Drive, again, is another thing that we can mount directly inside Nextcloud. You can mount your Google Drive inside your Nextcloud as a folder, and then you can collaborate with people who prefer Google products. Maybe they haven't seen the light yet, maybe they haven't used Nextcloud yet, but you can actually work with them because you can mount it as a subfolder. And if you want to migrate, you can mount it and just drag and drop it over, your files are over, and then you can unmount it, and then you migrate it away from Google, which is also nice. Talking about migration, that's also something that we expanded a lot lately, where you have this new option that with one click, you can migrate your Google contacts directly to Nextcloud as Nextcloud contacts. And again, you can migrate your Google calendars directly inside Nextcloud, to Nextcloud again with one click. And if you use Google Photos, again, with one click, you can import all your Google Photos into Nextcloud. It's very nice if you really want to get rid of your Google account and be using these open APIs to really connect with these services, and you can move your data around or just integrate them, of course. Okay, so the last company I want to mention is, of course, Microsoft. So Microsoft is one of our biggest competitors, especially in the enterprise space. They have products like Office 365, where we are the alternative to. We are like open source and GDPR compliant and decentralized and the open source, and I think the better and secure alternative. But some people still use Microsoft products. That's unfortunately how it is. So we also want to work with them. We want to integrate the APIs, again, to provide a migration path to move it over, to just be interoperable. The first thing we do is, again, same as before, you can actually mount your OneDrive inside Nextcloud and collaborate with people who are using the Microsoft platform also inside Nextcloud. And you can do the same with SharePoint. Maybe there's a SharePoint in an organization, and you can mount your SharePoint directly inside Nextcloud and collaborate with people, and you don't have to use SharePoint, but you still work on the same files. So that's something that's quite powerful. The second thing is, of course, Office Online. So Microsoft has this online editor that we can now also use directly as a fourth online office inside Nextcloud. So that's nothing we would recommend. We prefer the other solutions because they're open source and on-premise. But if you really, really have to, if you really want to use Word Online, Excel Online, PowerPoint Online, you can actually use them inside Nextcloud now. So we build a connector, and that's now possible if you want to. Obviously, you need a Microsoft license and Microsoft instance for that, but yeah, that's how it is. And the last feature I want to mention is chat. So as you know, Microsoft really is pushing Microsoft Teams forward a lot. So Microsoft Teams is this group chat that lots of people use. The most people I talk to, they don't like it too much, but I have to use it. But we developed this bridge again. So we have a bridge now from Nextcloud Talk to Teams, where you can bridge a Nextcloud Talk room into a Teams room. And everything you write on one side appears on the other side and the other way around. Okay? So you can really collaborate with people who still use this proprietary software, and then basically slowly convince them, hopefully, to switch over to the light and to an open source solution which doesn't have the vendor login from Microsoft. Okay, so these are the example integrations that we developed the last few months. Of course, we want to encourage more and more organizations to work with us, to connect the software, to collaborate together. And yeah, there's a lot more. I mean, there's a lot more integrations we did or others did. We worked together. I don't have the time to talk about all of them. There are a lot more, but we really want to encourage everybody to use our open APIs, our open app store, to bring the connector and bring your software into the Nextcloud ecosystem so that we provide this unified experience, as I showed you with some examples. Of course, it's still possible and still encouraged to write like not only integration app, but real applications on top of Nextcloud platform, real productivity applications. That's also something where we have a lot. And this is, of course, still important and yeah, very impossible and really, I hope, the future. Okay, so this is where we want to go. We want to go from a pure file sync and share solution to Nextcloud Hub, which is a full collaboration solution, to a platform, to a software that can work with everybody, that can talk with everybody. It's using open APIs, and everybody can integrate it, and we provide them together the user experience, which is hopefully good for everybody. So this is what we have for you today. So this is Nextcloud Hub 20. This is the biggest release so far. I think we showed you a lot of interesting, cool features, improvements, the search, the status, the dashboard, the performance improvements, and so on and so on. So there's really a lot. And of course, the second piece, which is the platform. So Nextcloud as a platform that really connects with everybody. So this is what we have for you today, which I think is very exciting. Of course, people then ask, okay, when is this available? When can I get all of that? When I can get the nice integration, when I can get the dashboard widget and so on. So as you might know, we from Nextcloud are not like other companies. We are not really big fans of pre-announcements. We only talk about things when they are ready. So I'm happy to say that everything we showed you today is available also today. Actually, I think it was released a few hours ago already, so you can already go today to our server, and you can download the software. Everything I showed you can already use today. And again, it's 100% open source and 100% free software and 100% self-hosted. So I really think that Nextcloud Hub is the solution for digital sovereignty, 100% open source. We are not affected by the whole Privacy Shield discussion. We are not affected by Cloud Act. We are per definition GDPR compliant because you can run it as you want, as it is compliant. That's something that's really important, and I really think we can provide you with the great usability and productivity combined with the security that you want. So I really think that in the current situation, the current COVID-19 situation, this is a big burden. This is a big problem for the world. A lot of people are struggling, working together, communicating, staying in contact socially from a work contact. And I really hope and I really think that Nextcloud Hub can help here by providing software where everybody can work together and collaborate and communicate. But it's very important that we do all of that without giving up control over our data and our digital freedom and our digital sovereignty and our private life and everything. We really have to do this by staying in control of our digital life. And I think the only solution for that, the only solution which is helps with COVID-19 and also still helps with our independence and privacy and security is software that's 100% open source and 100% on-premise. And this is what we are building with Nextcloud, and I hope we can help here to improve the current situation. Okay, so this is what we have prepared for you today. Please enjoy our conference, our online conference. You can still sign up, by the way. You can still go to conf.nextcloud.com, still register if you haven't. You have then get access to our own conference Nextcloud, conferencenextcloud.com, like a server where all the features I just showed you is installed, and you can use all those features, well, to test it, obviously, but also to collaborate with everybody else. So this is not just a stream. This is like actually a virtual collaboration conference, in a way. So please sign up, join our server and talk and chat, and everybody learn, listen to all the other talks, and hopefully become part of the community and hopefully help to shape the world a little bit to make it better. Thanks a lot.